Welcome to Thoroughbred Action from Gulfstream Park West. I'm Ron Nicoletti. It is Sunday afternoon. We've been dodging raindrops over the last couple of days, and we got nine we're going to show you. Let's check out those track and weather conditions and then turn it over to the one and only Pete Aiello.
Racing at GPW. From between horses, Diligent begins nicely. Star Weaver on the outside has speed. Keep an eye on Mike away in third. A gap of three to Reno Andromo, then Subject to Call and Last City. They speed to the half-mile grounds, and with the advantage, it's the favorite, Star Weaver. On top by a length and a quarter, Diligent is together with Keep an Eye on Mike. Keep an Eye on Mike now into second. A gap of another four to Subject to Call, racing ahead of Last City and Reno Andromo. Around the far turn they go, and Star Weaver tries to throw the knockout blow early on here. Leads by 2.5. Diligent tries to take up the slack second. Keep an Eye on Mike with a brief bid, but he's not gaining any ground. Back at the inside in Reno Andromo, then Last City as they splash for home. 3/16 to go, and the leader is Star Weaver now at the eighth pole. He's in front by five. Diligent down the center, Last City toward the rail, but nobody beats Star Weaver. Star Weaver will deliver on the odds-on promise. He's a long-gone winner of the Sunday opener. Star Weaver, dominant. Good battle for second. Too close to call for second between Diligent and Last City. Keep an Eye on Mike. Finish fourth. Social discussion was slow to go. Glitter Bay was quick to go and fires to the top. Glitter Bay now leads by a length and a quarter. VK Princess is second. Cairo Zeros away third. Pandorica is at the rail two better than Social Discussion. No speed from British Edge or Lady J with half a mile left to run. On the major class drop, Glitter Bay proves the superior speed as she's in front by five over Pandorica's second. VK Princess is back to third. Up on the outside, that's Cairo Zeros now fourth. From between horses and British Edge, backpedaling is Social Discussion, and Lady J has last a long way as they round the far turn. Up front, Glitter Bay has seen nobody but herself. She's in front at the quarter pole by 10. British Edge toward the inside of Pandorica, then it's Cairo Zeros and Social Discussion. Top of the lane, Glitter Bay in a race by herself. Eighth of a mile to go, Glitter Bay by 9. British Edge trying to eat into the margin and get into second. Cairo Zeros on the outside, third. But Glitter Bay, dominant in victory. She goes gate to wire while never facing a threat. Glitter Bay, easy, wrapped up by double digits. British Edge was second, Cairo Zeros is third. Close for fourth, Pandorica or Lady J, who flew home.
No problem. Run Happy, standing at Claiborne Farm.
And they're off. Good beginning for Mystical Moon up on the outside here. Smash moving out in between them and Bold Painter not far away. Surf Shack's away fourth. Back to fifth and Remember the Main, then Unlock the Potential, and Mr. Papillon toward the rail. In the charge to the first turn, the two favorites get acquainted. Smash on the outside toward the inside. That's Bold Painter, their heads apart. Two back to a third running Mystical Moon, and it's a length and a half to the rail. And racing from fourth is Surf Shack. Remember the Main's on his outside. Another two lengths to Unlock the Potential, and Mr. Papillon last. They roll into the backstretch, Smash on the outside, giving Bold Painter all he wants early. These two are going aggressively, 5 furlongs from home, 3 better than Mystical Moon, who's a rating third. A gap of 4 to Surf Shack, the rider keeping after him to try to stay in range. Then it's a length and a half to Remember the Main, 3 in front of Unlock the Potential, and Mr. Papillon is last. They've gone quick and contested through the opening half mile, and they converge on the lead. Now Bold Painter gets a neck in front as Smash is all in and dropping back. Mystical Moon taking on Bold Painter, who's had pressure every step. Up to third, Surf Shack. He was ridden to stay close, but he now has 4 lengths to find. Smash has dropped back, well clear of Unlock the Potential and Remember the Main, as they round the far turn to the top of the stretch with Bold Painter a narrow lead. Mystical Moon on the outside is second. Surf Shack hasn't gone away. He's 2.5 lengths down while rallying in the center of the course. 3/16 to go. Up the inside, Bold Painter trying to turn away all challenges. He's 1/8 of a mile from home and 3 on top. Surf Shack and Mystical Moon, they're battling second and third. Unlock the Potential tries to get Smash, but nobody gets Bold Painter. Bold Painter for Infinity Racing Stable to win, wrapped up by 5. Surf Shack was second, Mystical Moon third, then Unlock the Potential and Smash. From between horses, Union Lane gets the first call. On the far outside, Janet B does it all, being sent forward to get into position. Down at the inside, Broadway Cat, she hunts racing room toward the rail. Back from fourth and Vuyella, outside and just a bit sassy. Second last is Latre Jolie and Midnight Gem, last of the 7, as they charge around the first turn. Long shot Union Lane off the lead by 2.5. Janet B does it all is second. Broadway Cat third at the rail. Followed fourth by Just a Bit Sassy. Then it's Vuyella. A gap of 3 to Latre Jolie. And Midnight Gem is at the back. She's about 10 lengths off the lead of Union Lane. 5/8 left to run. Marcos Meneses and Union Lane by 1.5 lengths. Broadway Cat together with Janet B does it all. They're second and third. Just a Bit Sassy in range of the top horse as well. Fourth. Vuyella is next toward the rail. Then it's a gap of 6 to Latre Jolie. And Midnight Gem is last. That's the 7 of them as they swing to the far turn. 3 furlongs left to go. Union Lane has been in front from the outset and maintains a 2-length lead. Janet B does it all, tries to get after second. Broadway Cat is third. Just a Bit Sassy is fourth. Then Vuyella. But Union Lane continues up front. In fact, she's widened to touch. 1/4 mile left to go. Union Lane leads by 2.5. They're all chasing from the back. Midnight Gem's the one making ground. And they're at the top of the stretch. They're trying to reel in Union Lane to the attack. Broadway Cat switching to the clear. Vuyella down the stand side. Latre Jolie and widest of all, Midnight Gem. Final 1/8 of a mile. Here comes Latre Jolie, Vuyella, and Broadway Cat. Midnight Gem over the top. 4 with a chance here. Latre Jolie to the top. Latre Jolie in front. Close then for second. Either Midnight Gem or Vuyella. Fourth is Broadway Cat. Outside, Too Legit to Quit gets the first call. Gladys is away in good shape today. Up on the inside, Beyond Heavenly, and wide on the course, Village Queen. They're 4 across early. Down at the rail goes My Little Minx, sent forward to try to get into the top flight. Second last is Baby Melissa, and the early trailer is Unshakable You. As they sort themselves out around the first turn, the rail belongs to Beyond Heavenly, who now leads a half a length. Too Legit to Quit on the outside is second. Village Queen a three wide third. Gladys is now back to fourth. Up on the outside and Baby Melissa, wider than her, Unshakable You. And My Little Minx is last of the seven, improving a bit with 5 furlongs left to run. Up front, the leader is Beyond Heavenly. Now My Little Minx has moved through at the rail to take third, as Too Legit to Quit is in the flanking position from second. Gladys is now put between horses, and Village Queen is out wide. The two at the back remain Baby Melissa and Unshakable You. They swing now to the far turn, just above 3 furlongs from home. Up front, Beyond Heavenly leads narrowly. Too Legit to Quit is second. My Little Minx at the rail third, driven and not gaining. Gladys, pink colors on the outside, now into a joint third. Baby Melissa and Unshakable You are next. And Village Queen plummets to last as the leader remains Beyond Heavenly. Beyond Heavenly to the top of the stretch, leads by a length and a quarter. Far outside, Gladys. My Little Minx looks for rail position from between horses. Too Legit to Quit. Here comes Gladys on the outside, and Gladys is finding high gear now, and she's up to take the lead. Beyond Heavenly is back to second, then My Little Minx, and Too Legit to Quit. But here's Rachel's sister. Here's Gladys in front. Gladys wins, and wins going away. Beyond Heavenly was second. Third was My Little Minx, then Too Legit to Quit and Unshakable You. Between horses, Indy's Jewel sent forward to take the advantage from Bacano and Positive Phil. Devoted Kitten put into play up on the outside, splitting horses in Secret Lifestyle. Not So Subtle is next, and the two at the back are Budget Buster and the Duke of Monroe. In the charge around the first turn, Indy's Jewel leads narrowly as Secret Lifestyle is alongside in second. At the rail and Bacano from third, splitting horses in Positive Phil, three wide Devoted Kitten. A gap of two to Not So Subtle, racing toward the outside of the Duke of Monroe, and being eased out of the race is Budget Buster. The 12 has been pulled up. They race into the backstretch now, and up front, Indy's Jewel leads narrowly on the outside. Secret Lifestyle keeps the heat on second. Bacano third at the fence with 5 furlongs to run. Devoted Kitten is three wide. Positive Phil improves between horses. Not So Subtle is next. Ridden quietly by Paco and starting to gain some ground, and the trailer is the Duke of Monroe. They make their way past the half mile and swing to the far turn. Indy's Jewel still has command. Second, Secret Lifestyle. Third is Bacano. Not So Subtle moving toward the rail. Devoted Kitten is out wide. Dropping back a touch is Positive Phil, and the trailer is still the Duke of Monroe. Around the far turn they go. Indy's Jewel leads now by a length. Bacano into the clear with Devoted Kitten on the outside. Not So Subtle still has very big strides going. He's fourth and looking to tip to the clear with less than a quarter of a mile to go. Four in line as they turn for home. Devoted Kitten gets the lead. Not So Subtle tries to straighten up and go after him. Toward the rail, Indies' Jewel Bacano fights on between. Final eighth of a mile. Up in the center, Devoted Kitten has the lead. Not So Subtle is a bit green while racing into second, but the winner's Devoted Kitten. Devoted Kitten is in front. Not So Subtle was second. It's close for third. Either Indies' Jewel or Bacano, the Duke of Monroe, to complete the high five. Set for a start, and they're off. From the center, Beyond Magic and I'm a Daredevil, both well away, moving up between horses. Here's speed from Reggae Revolution as they scrimmage for early control. It's enough in the flight, so is Talk to Talk. The only one who's not part of the main brigade is Taylor VK. The scrum continues past the 5-8 and down at the inside. It's enough in front by Neck Revolution and on the outside second, Bohemian Girl now third. At the rail, the Gray Talk to Talk takes over fourth. Beyond Magic is next with I'm a Daredevil three wide and two back to Taylor VK. They leave the backstretch and move on to the far turn. Three furlongs left to run. It's enough on the inside by Neck. Three wide. Here's the move coming from I'm a Daredevil, who's on the go now, and I'm a Daredevil just ran on to take the lead. Reggae Revolution is in tight. Talk to Talk starts to thread the needle toward the rail, then back to Bahamian Girl, but I'm a Daredevil made first run on the embattled horses up front and is now in front by two. Talk to Talk angles to her flank to try to go after a second. Taylor VK from last is underway for a slice. Final eighth of a mile, it's all about I'm a Daredevil. I'm a Daredevil made the winning move at the 5/16 and wins going away. Talk to Talk clearly second. I'm a Daredevil clearly in front. Third is tight, but I think it's Beyond Magic over Bahamian Girl. Set. And they're off. Good start on the outside for Tis Possible Deer. Farther out in Bimini, sent through their inside. Royal Megan is on the go. Away in fourth, Independent Miss. Back to fifth and Worth Avenue. The two at the back are Cozy Dreams and Don't Get Cozy. Out of the chute, onto the main track, and Paco Lopez puts Tis Possible Deer on the engine here. She leads by a length and a half. To the two-path goes Royal Megan to race on from second. Independent Miss is together with Bimini, their third and fourth. It's a gap of three to Cozy Dreams, together with Worth Avenue, and Don't Get Cozy improves at the inside. They move to the far turn now, 3.5 furlongs from home. It's Tis Possible Deer on top. Royal Megan tries to get closer second. Independent Miss is now third. Bimini fourth. Zayas working overtime on Don't Get Cozy, who's back to fifth. Then it's Worth Avenue and Cozy Dreams. Around the far turn they go. Tis Possible Deer leads by a length and a half. Royal Megan is second. Three back to Independent Miss third. Bimini is backpedaling. Don't Get Cozy is next. 3/16 to go. Up front, it's Tis Possible Deer trying to go on with it here. Independent Miss rallies at the inside. Down the center, Royal Megan. Don't Get Cozy is fourth. 16th to go. Tis Possible Deer still finding on the top end for Paco. Tis Possible Deer. Gate to wire. Independent Miss second. Don't Get Cozy third, Royal Megan finished fourth, and Bimini to complete the high five. Away. Hero Tiger sent hard to try to get the early advantage, but so is Ed's Dog, and these two go out ahead of Iconic, who's away in early third. Up on the outside is the big favorite Avant Garde, and settling in fifth and last is Fifth Title. In the run around the first turn, Hero Tiger and Burgos get clear. They lead by a length over Ed's Dog in second. Lionel Reyes has the big favorite Avant Garde perched in third, about four lengths off the pace setter. Two better than Fifth Title, and then it's the gray Iconic, who's nearest the inside, last of the five, with five furlongs left to race. Up front, Hero Tiger on the quick turnaround. He has the lead by 2.5 lengths. Avant Garde on the outside claims second from Ed's Dog, who's back to third. Fifth Title is an early fourth, and at the rail, that's Iconic, fifth and last, as the pace is now a half a mile from home, with Hero Tiger committed for home. Hero Tiger leads by a length and a half now. Avant Garde starts to tighten in second. Fifth Title's on the improve. He takes third. Back to fourth, and Ed's Dog and Iconic with an inside lane. Three furlongs left to run, and the advantage still belongs to Hero Tiger. Avant Garde trying to get on terms. Reyes working a bit harder to get there. He's five ahead of Fifth Title, then it's Iconic, and at the back, Ed's Dog. Quarter of a mile left to go. Hero Tiger tackled by the son of Tonalist, Avant Garde, who's up on the outside and trying to get by. Four ahead of Iconic, who's a rallying third, then Fifth Title. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Avant Garde has a big fight on his hands as Hero Tiger is very game. Hero Tiger fighting hard. Avant Garde trying to lay in a bit. Avant Garde and Hero Tiger. Hero Tiger, Avant Garde. Avant Garde straightened up to win. Wasn't easy, but it was effective. Avant Garde for the money. Second was Hero Tiger. Fifth Title finished third. Iconic ran fourth.
That wraps up Sunday's action. We're dark for live racing on Monday and Tuesday. We'll be back here on Wednesday with a 9-race card. Our first race post is 12 p.m. And don't forget, you can watch and wager on all the races from Gulfstream Park on the First Bet app, also on expressbet.com, and you can stream the races live right on gulfstreampark.com. So enjoy it. Have a good night. Stay safe.
Hit the hay. I've been working all day, hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
What do you say? Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Well, I'm tired. Let me tell you, Jack, I'm so tired.